Welcome to Mates. This is the same man here, the Mates Ego. Right. So this video is on stationary point. You learn about how to determine, to calculate the stationary points of a curve. One. Two. You learn about how to determine the nature of these stationary points. Is it a maximum point or a minimum point? I will use more questions to make it simple and clear. Let's get started. Semangea, the Mates Ego. Right, so the first part is for you to be able to know what are stationary points. Stationary points just mean turning points. So it's another way of saying stationary points, right? These points also can be represented by terms maximum or minimum. Like for example, this one is my graph. Then I have my curve like this. This point and this point here, these are the turning points of the graph. These turning points are the ones which are called the stationary points, right? So this point and this point are the stationary points. This graph is about two stationary points or two turning points. Then the other thing, you have to know also based on minimum and maximum points. This point is the maximum stationary point. This one is the minimum stationary point, right? If I can draw my graph like this, this graph is a maximum point. This graph is a minimum point. That is the least possible point or value of y on this graph. That will define the minimum point, right? Then, what you have to know also is that on these minimum points or stationary points or maximum points or turning points, those are the ways which can represent the same thing. The gradient is always equals to zero. Gradient is always equals to zero. That's the rule or the concept that you always have to work with. Like, if you want to find the gradient of a curve, you have to draw a tangent at the point. Like, for example, if I want to find the gradient of this curve, let me draw it like this. Then this point, I have to draw a line or a tangent at this point. If it's a gradient at this point, I have to draw a tangent at this point. Then I just have to find the gradient of the tangent. So please, based on coordinate geometry, there's a topic that I have done, a video that I have done on my YouTube channel, at Larson Mangea. It's on the coordinate geometry actually. So you have to know the relationship between the tangent and the curve. To find the equation, to find the gradient of the tangent, use the same as finding the gradient of the curve at that given point. Then, if a line or a curve is like this, to find the coordinates or the gradient of this point, what I have to do basically is find the gradient of the tangent at that given point. If you can check here, the line will be horizontal. So a horizontal line is no gradient, or gradient is equal to zero. Also, if it's a vertical line, gradient is also equal to zero. What does it mean? It implies that gradient at turning points, maximum point, stationary points, is always equal to zero. So to find the coordinate point of the stationary point, what you do is simple. You just differentiate to find gradient, then you equate to zero to find the x coordinate of the points of our turning points. Then you can be able to also to find the corresponding y coordinates of the same. Then in that case, you can be able to find the coordinates of the turning points or stationary points. Then the nature of the turning points. How can you determine the nature of the stationary points? Is it a maximum point or a minimum point? Like as I explained earlier on, like this. This point is called a maximum point. This point is called a minimum point. Now, how can you use differentiation to determine the nature of these turning points? What you have to know is this. At stationary points, we differentiate twice. You say dy squared over dx squared. This is the one that you have to use. That's the second derivative of differentiation. So you differentiate twice. So the second derivative, if it's greater than zero, then you know this point is a minimum. If dy squared
over the x squared is less than 0, then you know this point is a maximum. So these are the two scenarios, situations that you have to work with to determine the nature of the stationary points. Is it a maximum or minimum? You just look at the second derivative. If it's greater than 0, it's a minimum point. If it's less than 0, then it's a maximum point. That's what you have to know. Like this. Right. Let's work with the questions now. Question number 1. Find by differentiation the coordinates of the turning points on the curve y is equals to 2x cubed plus 3x squared minus 12x plus 7. Stating the nature of each point, also sketch the curve. Right. So let's find the coordinates of the turning points on the curve. What you do? You differentiate. Find dy dx here. Equation is y is equals to 2x cubed plus 3x squared minus 12x plus 7. So by differentiation, you differentiate first. The first derivative, you say 2 times. So check my another video on differentiation, is on my YouTube channel, is there. You bring down 3 the power, then x the power 3 minus 1 plus 3 times bring down the power 2, then x the power 2 minus 1 minus 12, the power is 1 here. So you bring down 1 times x the power 1 minus 1. Differentiating a constant 7, you get 0. Always you have to know that. If you differentiate a constant, you get 0. So you don't have to write 7 or 0. Just leave it like that. Then 2 times 3 is 6. X the power 3 minus 1 is 2. Plus 3 times 2 is 6. Then 2 to the power x 2 minus 1 is 1. Then on this one, minus 12 times 1 is 12. Then x to the power 1 minus 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. It will be 0 here. X to the power 0 is 1. So it will be 12 times 1. It will always be 1. So you just write 12. That will be the first derivative of this equation. Right. So we know that at the turning points, gradient is always equal to 0. This one represents gradient. Dy dx is gradient. So you just equate this one to 0. X squared plus 6x minus 12 is equals to 0. Like this. You factorize, you find the coordinates, x coordinates are given this equation. First thing, you simplify this. Divide everything by 6, a common factor by 6. It will be x squared plus x minus 2 is equals to 0. Then find two values, which when you add, they give you plus x, and when you multiply, they give you minus 2x squared. Like this. What are these numbers? Which when you multiply, they give you minus 2. When you add or subtract, they give you x. You can find out that it's minus 2, it's plus 2 actually, plus 2x and x. So these are the factors. Then you replace the middle value, which is plus x, with the factors. How can you replace? It will be x squared plus 2x minus x minus 2 is equals to 0. Then you factorize here, x, then x minus x plus 2 here. You take 2, 2, this and this, this and this. X plus 2, then on this one, there's no common factor. You factor out minus 1, then it will be x plus 2 is equals to 0. Like this. Then x plus 2, they are the same in the brackets there. X minus 1 in the other bracket is equals to 0. So the values which are outside the bracket, this and this, you put them in their own bracket. Then these values which are the same, you also put them in their own bracket. Then you have to find the values of x here. It's either x plus 2 is equal to 0 or x minus 1 is equal to 0. X is equal to 0 minus 2, which is minus 2. Or x is equal to 0 plus 1, which is equal to 1. So these are the x coordinates of the turning points. Now you have to find the corresponding y coordinates. To find the corresponding y coordinates, you just use our equation. Our equation is what? You go up here. Y is equals to
2x cubed minus plus 3x squared minus 12x plus 7. Now you have the x coordinate. You can use the equation to find the y coordinate. So you say when x is equals minus 2, what will be y? Y is equals to 2 minus 2 cubed plus 3 minus 2 squared minus 12 times 2 times minus 2 then plus 7. So it's just like where there is x, you just put minus 2. Then you find your calculator. Then you just punch everything in your calculator. 2 bracket minus 2 cubed. Then minus plus just minus 2 cubed here to the power 3. Then plus 3 times 2 times minus 2 minus 12 times minus 2 plus 7. Then you get 9. So when x is equals minus 2, y is equals 9. That's the first point, minus 2 and 9. That's one of the stationary or turning points. Then you take another one. When x is equals to 1, what will be y? You write when x is equals to 1, y is equals to, now where there's x, you just put 1. To the power 3 plus 3, 1 squared minus 12 times 1 plus 7. Then you punch in your calculator. You punch in your calculator here. You say 2 times 1 is actually 2. Plus 3 times 1 is actually 3. Plus 2 times 1, 2. Plus 7 is 14. So you get 14 here. So what it means in this case is when x is equals to 1, y is equals to 14. That's another turning point or stationary point of this graph. You are done. Now you move on to the second part. Second part is on determining the nature of these turning points. Is it a maximum or a minimum? Also determine, stating the nature of each point. Is it a maximum or minimum? What you have to do is differentiate for the second time. So you take this one. That's divide x. 6x squared plus 6x minus 12. You write here 6x squared dy over dx is equal to 6x squared plus 6x minus 12. Then you differentiate d squared y over dx squared. D squared y over dx squared is equal to what? Differentiating this one, it will be 6. Then you bring down 2 here. It will be x to the power 2 minus 1 plus 6 here. You bring down 1, x to the power 1 minus 1. Differentiating a constant minus 12, what do you get? You get 0 here. So it will be 0 on this side. No need to write this one. Then 6 times 2 is 12, x to the power 1 plus 6 times x to the power 1 minus 1 is x to the power 0. X to the power 0, applying the laws of indices, is 1. So it will be 6 times 1 is 6. So that's d squared y over dx squared. Now what you have to do is you say you take the two points, turning points or stationary points here. We got x minus 2 and x minus 1. So you say when x is equals minus 2, what will be d squared y over the x squared? D squared y over the x squared will be equal to 12 here. You substitute where there's x, you put minus 2. Minus 2 plus 6. It will be minus 24 plus 6. Minus 24 plus 6 is minus what? 18. So if, as you can see, d squared y over the x squared is actually negative. If it's negative, it's less than 0. So this point is a maximum point. We can deduce that the point minus 2x minus 2y, what was y here? And x minus 2, y9. X minus 2y9. Then this one is a maximum point. Maximum point. Then also deal with the other one. when x is equals to 1, we found two values of x here. X is equals to 1, what will be d squared y over dx squared? So you write when x is equals to 1, then d squared y over dx squared is equals to 12. Then you put 1 where there is x plus 6. It will be 12 plus 6, which is 18. So this one represents that d squared y over dx squared is greater than 0. D squared y over dx squared is greater than 0, which means this point where x is 1 and y is equals to 14. It's 114. It's a maximum point. It's a minimum point. Minimum point. Then done. Now you have your maximum point and your minimum point. Done. Question number 2. The curve with the equation y is equals x squared minus 2x minus 8 is one turning point. Use differentiation to find the coordinates of the turning point. What you do? You differentiate. Then after that, equate to 0. Right? You just equate to 0. Both a stationary point, turning point, gradient is always equals to 0. That's dy dx. So you say dy over dx is equals to, then it will be 2x to the power 2 minus 1 minus 2, you bring down 1 because it's x to the power 1. Then it will be x to the power 1 minus 1. Differentiating a constant which is minus 8, you get 0, right? So you get 0. There's no need to write that one. It will be 2x here minus x to the power 1 minus 1 is 0. X to the power 0 is 1. 2 times 1 is 2. It will be 2 here. Then that will be your dy dx. Then at turning points, this dy dx is equal to 0. So you write 2x minus 2 equal to 0. 2x is equal to 0 plus 2, which is equal to 2. You bring down 2 to the right. It will be plus 2. So 0 plus 2 is 2. You divide by 2 here. By 2, you get x is equal to 1. Like this. X is equal to 1. That's the stationary x coordinate at the stationary point or turning point. Then you have to find, they said find the coordinates, which means they're supposed to be x and y. Then when x is equal to 1, what will be y? You say y is equal to, substitute in your original equation, it's 1 squared minus 2 times 1 minus 8. Then it will be 1 minus 2 minus 8. 1 minus 2 minus 8. 1 minus 2 is minus 1. Minus 1 minus 8 is minus 9. Like this. So the coordinate of the stationary point or turning point is 1 minus 9. X 1, Y minus 9. Then next, use the second derivative to test, to determine the whether this point is a maximum or a minimum point. So it differentiates twice. Dy dx is what here? Is 2x minus 2. That's dy dx. 2x minus 2. So you say d squared y over dx squared is equals to dy dx is 2x minus 2. So differentiating 2x minus 2, you get 2, you bring down 1, x to the power 1 minus 1. Then differentiating a constant, you get 0 here. No need to write it. It will be 2 times x to the power 1 minus 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. X to the power 0 is 1. 2 times 1 is 2. So d squared y over dx squared is actually greater than 0. What does it mean? It means it's a maximum point. So this one, at greater than 0, is a minimum point. So this turning point is actually a minimum point. Right, next, question number 3. Find the coordinates of the stationary points on the curve. Y is equals to x cubed minus 12x plus 10. And determine the nature of these points. Sketch the graph. So first thing, you want to find the coordinates of the stationary points or turning points. Then after that, you determine the nature by finding the second derivative. Then let's differentiate. Dy over dx is equals to, that one is x cubed, which means it's 3. X to the power 3 minus 1 minus 12, bring down 1, x to the power 1 minus 1, differentiating plus 10, a constant, you get 0 here. There's no need to write, but it will be 0. Then simplifying this one, 3x to the power 3 minus 1 is 2, minus x to the power 1 minus 1 is x to the power 0, which is 1, applying the laws of indices. 12 times 1 is actually 12. Like this. Then, at turning point, stationary point, gradient is equal to 0. Equate to 0, it will be 3x squared minus 12 is equal to 0. Find the x coordinates here. You say 3x squared is equal to 0 plus 12 is 12. Then divide by 3 by 3, you get x squared is equal to 4. Then x is equal to, remove the square, you put square root both sides. Remember? So square root of 4 is plus or minus 2. It will be x is equal to minus 2 or 2. These are the x coordinates of the stationary points. Then to find the corresponding y values, because they find the coordinates of the stationary points, you have to find x and also y. You say when x is equal to minus 2, what will be y? You substitute in your original equation. You say y is equal to minus 2 cubed minus 12 times minus 2 plus 10. You just find your calculator. That one, minus 2 cubed, you can put minus 8 right away. Then plus 24, minus 12 times minus 2 is plus 24. Then plus 10, you get 26. So you have a coordinate, minus 2x and 26y. This one is one of the coordinates of the turning points of this graph. Then the other one, you say, when x is equal to 2, what will be y? Y is equal to 2 cubed minus 12 times 2 plus 10, which is equal to 2 cubed is 8 in your calculator, minus 2, 12 times 2 is 24, then plus 10, you get minus 6. Minus 6. The coordinate is 2 and minus 6. So these are the two turning points or stationary points of this curve. Then determine the nature of these points. You differentiate second time, find the second derivative, divide the x here over the x is 3x squared minus 12. So differentiating 3x squared minus 12, you find the squared y over the x squared is equals to, you say 3 times, bring down 2, x to the power 2 minus 1, differentiating constant, you get 0, no need to write. Then it will be equal to 3 times 2 is 6, x to the power 2 minus 1 is 1. So it will be 6x. Then to find the nature, now you find the first coordinate when x is equal to minus 2, what is the squared y over the x squared? So you write when x is equal to minus 2, then the squared y over the x squared is equal to, then you substitute here, 6 times minus 2, what do you get? It's minus 12. So it's negative. When x is equal to minus 2, the squared y over the x squared is negative. Remember, when the squared y over the x squared is negative, is less than 0, then this point will be a maximum point. So you say this one is a maximum point. So this one is a maximum point. Maximum point. Then let's find when x equals to 2. Right? When x is equal to 2, the squared y over the x squared is equal to, then you say 6 times 2, which is equal to 12. Yes? Which means is greater than 0. The squared y over the x squared is greater than 0. It's a minimum point. So this one is a minimum point. Right. Now to sketch the graph now, you have two turning points, minus 2 and 26. X minus 2. Let me just put it like this one. X minus 2. Y is equals to 26, yes, and x2, y is minus 6. It's 26, maybe there's 26 somewhere here. Let me just sketch it somewhere here. Then I plot Then x2, another turning point, x2, y minus 6 is here. X2, y minus 6. X2, yeah, I can put 2, yeah. Then y, I can put minus 6, yeah. That's another turning point. Uh-huh. So this one is a maximum point. So your graph will be like... Then I want to find the coordinate of y. You need to find the y coordinate where the this graph crosses or cuts the y axis. Or you just put 0, yeah? Where there's x, just put 0. X 0. So it will be y is equals to 0 cubed minus 12, 0 plus 10. So if you can simplify this one, you get y 10. Ah. So at the y axis, then the value of x is always equal to 0. What you just do to find the point where the graph cuts or crosses the y-axis, just put x0 on the equation. Uh-huh. Substitute in your equation x0. Then you find the y-coordinate. Then in this case, we found that y is equal to 10. So the graph cuts the y-axis at y is equal to 10. Yeah? I can put y10, yeah? That's where... I can put like this. Then this one is the turning point. This one is the turning point. That will be your graph. Then you are done. That will be your graph. That's a sketch. Right, next. So to sketch the graph, just put the coordinates points of the turning points, actually, or stationary points. Then find the points where the graph crosses the axis, actually. Crosses the axis. Right, question number 4. The curve y is equal to 2x cubed plus ax squared plus bx is a stationary point x is equal to 2. The curve passes through the point 123. Find the value of a and the value of b. Right, this one is a different question, but same concept. The curve, we are given the curve in terms of a and b, is a stationary point when x is equal to 2. So it means when x is equal to 2, the gradient is equal to 0. That's what that's the first part. Then the curve passes through the point 123. So using this point 123 and using the point x equals to 2, you are going to form two equations in a and b. Then you solve them simultaneously as simultaneous equations. Right? So first thing, you can use this equation. You can use the point 123. It means x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 23. You substitute in the equation. You say 23 is equal to 2. Where there is x, you put 1 cubed plus where there is x, you put 1 squared plus b times 1. You find the first equation. 23 is equal to 2 times 1. 1 cubed is 1. 2 times 1 is 2. Plus 1 squared is 1. Times a is a. Plus b times 1 is b. Then you can have your equation here. 23 minus 2 is equals to a plus b. From this you can say 21 is equals to a plus b. You can write it as a simultaneous one. The way you present simultaneous equations is equals to 21. A plus b is equals to 21. This will be your first equation. Then to find the second equation, you use the point, stationary point x is equals to 2. When x equals to 2, gradient is equal to 0. So you differentiate here. You find dy over dx. Then it will be, let me write it here. 2, bring down 3 here. X to the power 3 minus 1. Plus a, bring down 2 here. The power 2 minus 1 plus b. Bring down 1, the power x to the power 1 minus 1. It will be 2 times 3 is 6, x to the power 3 minus 1 is 2, plus then x to the power 2 minus 1 is 1. It will be 2 times a is 2 here, yeah, to the power x, then here, yeah, b, x to the power 1 minus 1 is 0. 1 minus 1 is 0, x to the power 0 is 1, 1 times b is b. So it will be plus b, this part. Then you can just, right, when x is equal to 2, there's a stationary point. What you do now is to put x2. then you equate to 0. Gradient will be equal to 0. 6, 2 squared plus 2, 2 plus b, you say is equal to 0. 2 squared is 4, 4 times 6 is 24, plus 2 times 2 is 4, plus b is equal to 0, like this. Then there's supposed to be an a, yeah? It's 2 times a, 2 times a, so it's 4a, 4a plus b. Then you can write 4a plus b is equal to 0 minus 24 is 24. That will be the second equation, number 2. Right, now you have two simultaneous equations. You have to find the value of a and b. You can use elimination, you can use substitution. Let me use elimination here. You can say equation 2 plus b is equals minus 24. Then a plus b is equals to 21. Use elimination. You can find the values of a and b. You subtract here. So that they are supposed to be a 0 on b minus b. 4a minus a is 3a here. Then there's a 0 here. Then minus 24 minus 21. 8, there's a 5 here. The 4, it will be minus 45. Then to find a, divide by 3 here. Divide by 3, you get a is equals minus 15. Then to find b, you substitute in any of the equations. Let me choose equation 1. In equation 1, when a is equals minus 15, then you say minus 15 plus b is equals to 21. Then it will be b is equals to 21 plus 15. Like this. Your b will be equal to 21 plus 15 is 6, yeah? Is 36. Then in this case, you can say that you have found the values of a and b. Then done. Right, so that's the end of these questions. I'm sure you've learned enough. Subscribe, like the video, share the video. Say Mangia, the Maths Ego. Watch out other, there are lots of videos on my YouTube channel. Look out for them. Check out Say Mangia. Signing out. Bye.